It's been approximately 28 days and I'll be trying the three experiments right now. The thing I found interesting is with this sprout or pup, the growth is a bit different than I usually see. There's a flat round It's a flat round pup, and only later do the ribs actually start to appear. So these are the controls. Two of them had pups. It's all of the zeros. Zero, 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 zero. And let's get a weight. So I don't have the starting weight on hand, but I'll edit it in. It'll be around 300 grams. Let's see. 304 grams. This is the control. Now for the single treatment at 20 milliliters per liter of the True Color solution. This is at 281 grams. And these were treated every 2 days with the same solution for 2 weeks. And then the 2 weeks prior to this weighing, it was just kept in the same conditions as the control and the experiment, the one treatment. And this one is at 275 grams. So I'll do a comparison to the starting weights. And as I cut them, if I notice anything different, I'll share that as well. Visually, there isn't much difference between them. The tone of the green, all of them got different shades, so there isn't much of a visual difference. The only real difference that I noticed, but one of the multiple treatment sets also had a pup. I was going to mention that only the controls had new pups, but that's not the case. And yeah, I'll cut these open and then dry them to get the dry weight. Here are the three experiments. The control, zero. One is a single treatment with the True Color, and two were the multiple treatments of the True Color. Overall, there wasn't a huge difference. There is a darker tone to the multiple treatments. However, that could just be from excess drying or something. I can't really tell at this point. But yeah, the three treatments, I'll be placing them in uniform containers. I'll be using a uniform lye solution with salt and 100 milliliters of xylene for each, and I'll do 2 or 3 pulls each, and it'll be over a course of a week. I'll leave it a few days and then remove the xylene layer and then repeat it, and sometime next week I'll start salting. And here they are after using a uniform 100 milliliters of a lye salt solution and 100 milliliters of xylene. The difference in the xylene level is probably just the bottle size, because I use the same measuring beaker, so it should be fairly uniform, maybe a few milliliters difference. So just first observations, it means absolutely nothing, but only the single treatment and an entire month in a drought condition, it is the only one that has a very dark, cloudy xylene layer. I've already shaken these 3 times, and the single application is the only one with lots of oils, which I observed the first attempt as well. I'm quite surprised by this one, since it had the most treatments. I don't know if it's because it received so many treatments that it ended up consuming the oils or alkaloids or whatever this discoloration is. And the control is the clearest of them all, followed by the multiple treatments. And yeah, the shading could mean absolutely nothing in terms of the yield, and it's just a observation that I'm doing. In my first attempt with a single true color application, I also observed the higher impurity, or the red color shading impurity on this one. Using pure ethylene or ethylene substitute, it caused the cleanest profile, where it was similar to this. It was very light and had fewer impurities compared to the control and the treatment. So a single treatment, just like the first time, it increased, at least visually, certain secondary metabolites, and the multiple treatments, to my shock, is much clearer. So I'll leave this for a few days and then save the liquids, the xylene solvent, apply another 100 milliliters, and I'll do that just 2 times. In the past I've done it 3, and there's a minimal return on the 3rd pull. So just 2 times would be enough. It's already separating quite well. I can actually just speed up the process, but I prefer to leave it a day or two pulling the alkaloid till it's saturated. There's no real rush, and it allows it to bubble up and separate completely. And in case I wasn't clear the first time, I add salt to the lye solution, since it helps with the separation of the solvent and the aqueous layer. You can see a small color impurity here, but it tends to fall down out of solution. But yeah, so control is the clearest, followed by the multiple treatments, and a single application has the highest color impurity, which could mean nothing in terms of total yield. We'll see that in the future.